SIMS TV!
No one knows Cold as Ice by Foreigner.
I know that song very well.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to SIMS TV.
Macho fries.
More importantly, is that a baby? I see like a head.
Welcome to Sims TV today. I think it's September 11th. Today on the show, we have Dan Hurt and Tom Kay from the Best Best Friends podcast in the world. Of course, Kara is on with us. And here's Sims.
Oh, my. Oh, my. How is everyone?
Feeling good.
Feeling groovy. Well, I am so excited to have Tom and Dan on tonight. We're going to get to them here in a bit. Mike, Kara, great to see you. Talon Booker, Mike, we'll get to that in a minute. Kara, we'll get to where you are here in a minute. But before we get started, I do want to share something. And I actually wrote something, so bear with me as I look down at my notes. It's with heavy heart I must share that one of our own has passed away today. Earlier, the great Randall the Trash Man Cunningham left this earth for doggy heaven. Our deepest sympathies go out to Randy's owners, Dylan Stern and Anya Christensen. We're sending lots of love and thoughts your way. For those of you who knew Randy, he wasn't just Dylan and Anya's dog. He was, in fact, the Trash Man. From the time he showed up on the front lawn of the compound to dragging full bags of trash up the steps to his twin-sized dog bed, Randy was loved by everyone, especially the ladies. For me, he was the first dog that I lived with, and I couldn't have asked for a better, more lovable roommate. He helped me get over my fear of dogs and showed me that even a scary-looking Doberman can be the sweetest of sweet. At this time, I would like to take a moment of silence and remember this amazing dog and the joy that he brought to this world. At this time, Dylan and Anya, despite the day they had today with losing Randy, were able to put together a little video. We just got it delivered to us. I haven't even seen it yet. So let's go to it. Ladies and gentlemen, Randall, the Trash Man Cunningham. Well, I know it though. He's my little brother. Everybody says we're going to be good friends tonight.
I'd like to eat.
To Randy, everyone. That dog, I mean, to Randy. Rest in power, my friend.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to say that. And again, to Dylan and Anya, we really, really send our deepest sympathies here. I personally don't believe in God or pray, but if I did, it would be for you two. But on a brighter note, I do want to touch on how Randy got his name. And Mike, I know you don't know because you don't know Randy that well or at all. or and Kara, you essentially grew up with Randy. But Randy was the house dog that that used to live with us in the compound, which was the house we lived in our 20s when we lived in LA. And it was a big party house. And Dylan found Randy on the front lawn one day. He was a Doberman. He was a stray. Randy brought him in, or Dylan brought Randy in, and he became our house dog. And I remember, you know, we would get drunk on a Tuesday and order a bunch of Taco Bell, and we'd throw away the Taco Bell at night. And then the next day I'd be like getting up, going to work, and Randy would be slaughtering up the stairs, carrying the trash bag from the trash can with all the Taco Bell falling out. So we gave him the name the Trash Man, and bring a little humor back to everything and to remember why we loved him so much. Here is why he is known. I mean, he's known as the Trash Man for eating literal trash, but one last tribute for Randy. This is for you, Randall.
The most important part of our routine is the entrance.
Yes, absolutely. Whoa!
Frank, what the hell are you doing, man?
That's my character. I'm the Trash Man. I come out, I throw trash all over the ring. And then I start eating garbage. And then I pick up the trash can and I smash the guy on the head.
Oh, that's going to be a disaster.
No, nobody's going to get hurt. I'm telling you, it's like you said, it's all fake.
But it has nothing to do with the troops, Frank. A 60-year-old man eating trash? Who wants to see that?
No, but that's what people want.
Hey, I got something for you. I got a character for you. You can be the ref.
I'm not going to be the ref. I'm a villain, don't you see? Look at the garbage.
Frank! Just nasty, dude. Are you choking? Oh, my God. No, throw it up in the bathroom. Get out of here. Don't take a break. The troops are going to be very happy to see that.
I love that dog so much. I mean, I was just like heartbroken today, but I just want to say thank you again for all of our fans, for the comments and the love that you're sending. It's a comedy show, so let's check in with our talent booker, who did book tonight's guest. First off, question from Dave: is Kara in the Outer Banks with Mike? Are you?
I am. We're in neighboring rooms. Myself and his wife.
Wait, Mike, what's that echo? Where are you? Shut that door and show us where you are.
Also, like, what's the shower curtain over the door in my area?
He's in the bathroom.
I'm trying to find a quiet place, man.
The echo is lovely. How's the beach treating you?
The beach is good. This body's not built for sand and sun, so.
Well, yeah, you know, what do you mean it's not built for sun?
Dude, I mean, I grew up in Texas, but I mean, my arms are kind of tannish, but once you get past this sleeve, man, it looks like the printer from the paper from the printer.
Paper from the printer. Who isn't fucked up tonight? That's my question. Kara, what are you doing over there in the Hamptons?
I'm at my best friend, Sarah Braswell's house. Sarah Egan, as of the last like couple years. I haven't been over here for the whole like quarantine. But you know, there's a couple couples outside having some drinks. I've been hanging out since like 3 p.m. my time, so like 7 hours. But well, I'll say RIP, you know, rest in peace, Trash Man. I thought Randall was great. I mean, he hung in with the fucking compound, and he wandered up to the, you know, I mean, we can't do him justice. I think Dylan and Anya can obviously do him the most justice as far as how.
He was the king of the dick sniff. He loved a good dick sniff.
He was the king of the dick sniff. But I loved Dylan's comment, excuse me, Trash Man, because it was Susie just being like, everyone was calling him Trash Man because he would just constantly get into the tuna cans. And she's like, didn't really understand why he was called Trash Man, but she was like,
she respectively called him that.
Excuse me, Trash Man. Like, it was like, oh, I'm sorry. Are you, you're in the way. Anyway, I'm at Sarah Braswell's house. I cannot believe the news about Randy, and obviously We also had a loss in the family last week. Marky Vlandingham also. There was a dog. So, you know, we're just getting older, and this is a facts, you know, fact of life, and it fucking sucks. And we're all, it sucks. It does suck.
It does.
I'm an owner of two cats, as everyone knows. And it's like, I don't want to know the day. So I'm
the owner of three dogs, and I do want to know the day. That's a whole other story.
I don't want to tell you I want to know the day, but
I would have easily sacrificed Mickey for Randy. Easily. I mean, Mickey's the fucking devil. Yeah. And Mickey, my Chihuahua, used to hang out with Randy, and by hang out, Randy was terrified of him. Yeah. And it was just like, this Chihuahua's a fucking dickhead. Yeah. All right. So Mike, what have you been doing at the beach?
Drinking. Chasing kids, trying to break up fights of he's touching me, she's touching me, hanging out with the family. We traveled with a friend of ours with two kids.
I got a little bit of inside. I got some real footage of you at the beach.
I kind of regret this now.
No, you don't regret
this. I don't know what I look like. This is my first time watching this.
Gone are the days of chasing tail. Now it's just
chasing kids.
Now it's just chasing Doug and
when he first said that, I was like, what? Oh, kids. Got it. Okay. Well, we got some exclusive footage of Talent Booker Mike at the beach. Let's go to that right now, and we'll hop right back into this, and we'll bring out our guests, Dan and Tom. All right, Mike at the beach. Shorts.
Listen, America.
You know, the one thing I didn't see a lot of mask wearing in those videos. I was surprised.
He's at the non-mask wearing beach. You know, only thing they're wearing at that beach are thong bikinis.
That was gorgeous, though. I think everyone. I mean. We just don't want to turn everyone on too much. It's not that kind of show. So like.
Speak for yourself. anyway, Travis, I think says it best. Glad we're back to the comedy. Well, that being said, I want to get to our guests. I'm going to let Talent Booker Mike introduce him because he most certainly did his job as the Talent Booker and booked the shit out of them this week. And literally booked them at the last
Thursday. On Thursday.
On Thursday was we had a cancelization. Not that I wanted these guys to be second tier, but we just bumped them up from later in the season. And Mike took care of it and got him on. And Mike, you want to introduce him?
Yeah, these two guys have a podcast about beer and friendship. It's Dan Herb and Tom Kay from the Best Friends podcast in the world.
Woo!
Whoa, we're in there.
What up?
There they are. They've been waiting for 16 minutes.
Oh I know. I'm God. Almost finished this beer. I poured it.
We were hoping you guys could get as good as drunk as. oh my gosh! I'm sorry. I paused for a minute. This guy, Mike. Do you remember him? Remember Adam from the early Sims TV days on Periscope?
Yeah, I do.
There he is. He's back. Adam, welcome to the show. Sims TV is still alive and kicking.
That last name is awesome. Adam Jolicoeur.
Is that how you say it? Jolicoeur.
Jolicoeur. I don't know.
Anyway.
That's what Kara's been drinking all day. Jolicoeur.
Yeah. Kara found out that there was we're doing a show
last
with
is a sobriety test.
Yeah. I did bring a beer so you guys can like have a
what is that? So is that a cotton candy beer?
No, it's like
oh, look at that. She's drinking with us in unity.
Have you seen this? We'll look at it later.
We'll look at it later. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So
can I say that it was very nice of Mike to let David Hasselhoff ride him through the waves. He's
that's
a boat,
so
folks.
Fucked up. What the fuck,
and folks? I'll be here all week.
I think the first question of the night is, and well, I do want to touch on that. If I had more time, I would have put Mike's head on David Hasselhoff. But time was of an essence. The question is, are you guys twins?
We're very close.
We're like the Danny DeVito and Arnold Schwarzenegger twins.
We are. Yeah. We're two best friends who are separated by probably mere hours of birth.
Well, yeah.
Well, let's take a look. Let's take a look real quick. Like, okay, here's Tom. Mm-hmm. There's Tom looking handsome and
okay. I swipe right.
Oh, swiping ooh. Right. He's married, but it's okay.
Oh, okay.
Well, I mean, at your age,
I swipe half right.
At your age,
thank you, Kara. At my age, I need that ego boost.
Yeah, you're welcome.
All right, let's see if she'll swipe right to Dan.
Yeah, I mean, they look the same. He has less facial hair. I
always have facial hair. I shaved this morning, but it didn't matter.
He's at max capacity right now.
Right, yeah. But more tattoos. Does he have more tattoos?
Yeah. Oh yeah,
okay. I've got.
So that like balances it out, I think. Anyway,
That's my beard.
Got it.
It's the beard. And let's see Tom's hair. Tom has the quarantine hair going.
Yeah, I got a. I'm gonna pop off my old cans here. I got the cabbage coming out of the back here.
He's got like the mid '90s relief pitcher hair going.
Oh, like take back what I said. Swipe left.
Swipe left.
Wow. So, all right, Kara.
That was quick. That was a.
How quickly we become enemies?
Chicken or whatever you call it, prize pig. So
yeah, you're not.
She sobered up really quick and was like, "Nope."
Prize pig.
Right? Yeah, prize pig. I like that one.
I like prize pig too.
That's right.
That's rough.
All right. So you guys got a podcast, and before we get too fucked up, let's talk about the podcast. Tell us about it. What's going on? What are you guys doing besides drinking beer?
Jeez. This podcast has been through so many different iterations. It was really just like a podcast about two buds, two best friends. You know, there are other best friends podcasts out there, but we're the best best friends podcast in the world. So it kind of started off as like we were just hanging out, talking about random stuff, and we both have
cringe videos and stuff.
Yeah, and we have a certain love for beer, craft beer in general. You know, Dan had this shiesty plan where he wanted to eventually turn the podcast to where it is now. So he started sliding it in, like, hey, let's do some craft beer.
I just started bringing like a little lunch bag of beers over every time we did the podcast. I'm like, hey, I got this new beer. We should try and maybe talk about it. I don't know.
Where do you guys live?
We live outside of Philadelphia.
I'm just like, I'm asking for a friend. but you do. Okay. Live outside of Philadelphia. So do you only tap into Philadelphia beers, or do you go like beyond the circuits?
So we try to get outside of the local craft beer scene. You know, the whole virus kind of put a little
damn pandemic.
Yeah, threw a little wrench into that. And
are you on vacation with Todd? I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, we try and get outside of our local area.
I'd say we do a lot of like regional beers and stuff. So it's like, you know, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Delaware, New York. But we're really starting to target, I guess we coined it last episode, the internet darlings of the craft beer world. You know, the ones that people are posting a lot about on social media. We want to kind of get our hands on so we can talk about them.
What about this craft beer?
Yeah, I was gonna say it's weird. I don't follow any of those people, but I'm interested in whatever the hell you are following.
It's a crazy lane on Instagram with craft beer. It's
filled with it's filled with a lot of good beer and a lot of boobs.
I was gonna say he was gonna. I was like, go on, come on,
a lot of thoughts, of thoughts.
But what about boobs and beer? Are they combining? I guess is the real question.
Oh, followers, like, followers of like, money, followers of like money is what they're targeting.
The beer on the boobs, or are they just like what? What does that mean? Beer and boobs. Oh, hey, dude behind Mike.
Oh, that is.
Uncle Joe, what up, Uncle Joe Bob?
I have an infant sleeping right outside this wonderful shitter.
Who is it?
It's Tom.
Tom, what happened?
Tom,
this app is destroying our camera app. Oh no. What's happening here?
Yeah, but who's the guy behind Mike with his hand? I trust him. I trust you.
Somebody broke into our condo.
Oh, shit. Watch out behind you, bro.
I believed you. I was like, right now? Tom, I'm going to take you off for a minute so you have a minute to get yourself fixed, and we're going to talk to Dan.
Oh, awesome. I get to talk to him. Tom's usually the face of the podcast.
You get the spotlight, baby.
All right, nervous Dan. Now. All right, as Tom's fixing his janky camera, tell us a little bit. How do you guys know each other?
So Tom and I, we met when we were like in 10th grade, I guess. We've been best friends for a very long time.
Did you ever come when he was at Robert Morris? Do you ever come visit or anything?
That's a very good question there. I believe, the first time I met Mike was a memorable experience at Robert Morris College.
Was I there then? You're on mute, Mike.
Unmute yourself for this one.
No, it was a foggy night for me too.
I was gonna say I didn't know if this Mr. Sims was at this party, but
no,
this was probably one of the most memorable parties I've ever been to with Tom.
It was at my house, right? Wasn't it at my house?
Yeah, it was at your house.
My invite must have got lost in the mail. Thanks, Mike.
Bitch, you were in California already.
I would fly back for something like that.
It's that postal service, you know? I mean, god damn it.
I need my packages on time.
Tom, right? Do you think Tom's cussing up a storm right now? Just like, motherfucking camera.
I'm gonna chat him for a second because I fixed mine and I know how to fix his. So like,
chat him real quick. In the meantime,
we'll talk amongst ourselves. Man, these fucking guests. Ugh, I hope they get to like talking about beer soon because I'm drunk.
Well,
I'm sorry, Dan. I didn't know you're still coming.
I'm still here.
I'm sorry. Sims, what you drinking? PBR? I feel like that's like a classic.
What's that? What did Tom say?
Oh, his internet went down. Okay, we'll get him.
Oh, maybe there's like a tornado. Is there a
tornado coming?
No, we're on the East Coast. There's no tornadoes.
Is there a PA tornado? No.
I'm drinking a PBR. I'm not a classy beer drinker.
Oh, it's the drink of champions. I mean, it's an easygoing beer. It's always going to be the best option when there's nothing else available.
It's not our Keystone. I usually drink Keystone because I can get 15 for $8 PBR's at Aldi. At
like 2 a.m. girl, where you're just about to leave and you see her and you go, all right, let's go.
Oh, geez. Well, it's good to know that I still got my 2 a.m. girl. Yeah, Kara.
Oh, speaking of 2 a.m. girls, hey, Kara.
It's basically 7 a.m. It's like I've been in this for 7 hours.
Oh, Spencer wants to know, is the guy with the stairs single? Let's get a, if not, we got a, are you single?
No, I am married as well.
Oh, everyone's married.
Married with kids.
How many kids do you have?
Actually, kid. I have one kid. She is 15 months.
I think you're going to say 15. I was like, holy hell. You got busy.
I know. Now. I look good for my age, right?
Yeah, you look great. But Mike has 15 kids. Yeah. They were all in his past van last week.
Yeah, like, give or take, he's got 15. I mean, there's I just can't get over this door that's a shower curtain, but it's clear. Like,
I feel like this is a total dad move for a guy who's doing an internet TV show and has a bunch of kids.
But what a sweet man you are, Mike.
Every time I see you, Mike, you get more gray hairs, and then the roll on the back of your head gets larger. You know that Uncle Phil roll, like the Fresh Prince of Bel Air.
Wait, hold on. Drum roll. Everyone do the drum roll for Tom.
Oh, he's back in.
Oh,
there he is. Hey. Wow.
What, you lose your internet?
Did you scream
you,
at
Comcast? Am I allowed to curse on this show?
Yeah, you can do whatever you want.
Fuck you, Comcast.
I don't think there's a way we could ever bleep anything. I don't think there's.
Oh, that's the wrong thing to tell me.
Yeah.
We're gonna let him go.
Everybody's getting canceled tonight.
If you're watching, you know what this show's all about.
I like Josh's question. Like, Mike, what do you do? I mean, is that a shower? Is that a drop trowel? Like, what is this clear door there?
Do you have more showers?
Yeah, I was going to say, are there two showers in there?
Bathtub.
Oh, okay.
Shitter.
Oh, my God. It's kind of sexy. Like, it's like a sexy getaway, I'd say.
Yeah, you're real bougie when you have a separate bathtub and a shower in there.
Like, I mean, you know, you could have someone showering in the like clear section. You could have someone showering, like, but they don't have to be the together. It could be like a couple over here, a couple over there, someone shitting over there.
Oh, like, I could tell Larkin, fuck you, Larkin.
Yeah, okay.
Mike is used to using a bathroom with two stalls that have had all the stalls knocked down.
Oh my gosh, that's legendary story right there.
Yeah, so what's the deal? So you guys all went to college together. Am I the outlier here?
No,
I'm also an outlier as well.
I met Dan like 12 hours ago on text. I went to college with Tom and Mike. Mike and I were in the same fraternity. And from what I remember and from what Mike told me minutes before the show, Tom pledged twice but never got in, which is the coolest thing. Which is like cooler than anything, Tom. Trust me. I would love to go back
in time. It's all a blur.
Love to go back in time and pledge twice but never get in. That's so much cooler than being like, I was in a fraternity for 4 years. You know, like, good for you, Tom.
You know,
third time's a charm, man.
You know, try.
Go back now and try to get in.
You know, the second time was really, I just kind of stopped.
It wasn't even like
you're out or you're in. I was like, I'm just going to stop.
It was a mutual agreement.
I don't even know it was mutual. Mike and I moved off campus and I was just like, yeah, I'm kind of done with this whole thing.
Yeah. Well, you know, I still love you. I threw a spatula at your head once and you almost lost your eye. Remember that?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
That was fucking scary.
Yeah, I remember my eyebrow punching one of your eyes out.
Yeah, a lot of stuff has happened to my eyes between these two. So, always go for the eyes like monkeys.
So, you guys, let's get back to the podcast. So, you started the podcast. You're talking beer. You're best friends. How long have you been doing the show?
We are at about 9 months or so. I don't know. We're a year in January.
All right. Should we show a little clip? You guys got a clip here. It's actually really funny. It's called Scissor Judge. And do you guys want to set it up or do you want me to set it up? Because I'll set it up a totally different way, I think, than you will.
Yeah, I mean, for this video here, this is where we kind of turned and went full craft beer with our podcast because we brought on a friend who was also a beer cicerone. So it was kind of, for anyone who like doesn't know what a cicerone is, it's kind of like a wine sommelier. So like somebody who's like, you know, studied craft beer.
Ooh, I like that pronunciation. Sommelier.
Did you like that one? That's good.
Yeah, I like that.
This
next beer, I'm not going to be able to pronounce it, so I'm trying to get it out now.
No. Cicerone. Yeah, no, I go, that's a wine sommelier.
Sommelier? Sommelier?
Yeah, no, that's a wine sommelier pirate.
Saucisson is sausage in French.
She
knows sausage in French.
Let's show a quick video. All right, we're going to show a video. This is, you guys have your beer Somalian pirate on. Here we go.
So I got to bring up the beer snob in me. Have you guys ever talked about like how to drink certain beers?
No.
No, we've never actually gotten down to that.
I got being in the industry and everything, I got my Cicerone, which is basically a sommelier for wine. I'm a Cicerone is for beer.
You're so a beer Cicerone?
I'm a snob McSnobenstein, and I enjoy it very much.
How did you become one of these? Because I feel like...
It's just a class you take on the interweb.
I feel like we have to do this, Tom.
It's super easy.
We have to have certifications on the wall.
Oh, yeah. Level one is for restaurants.
The word makes me think that you judge, like, scissoring techniques.
Yeah. I'm a Cicerone.
I'll do that, too. I mean... Applicants.
Oh my God, we're applicants. Scissoring.
Just not enough core in that. You really have to.
You have to really get those.
Engage the core.
Have you ever seen what a pair of scissors look like? You look like nothing like that. Yeah.
You look like safety scissors right now.
Yeah, you're those Mr. Owl scissors. No, so.
Okay, so we're going to get out of this stuff. How would you drink this beer then?
So. IPAs and stuff like that.
Butt
chug.
Yeah, that would end poorly. It's a sip and then a gulp. So your first sip is to kind of open your palate.
Okay.
And the second is like a nice gulp.
Okay, so it's not sip gulp in the same motion.
No, it's like a perfect little, and then.
I kind of do that sometimes. Okay. So that's how I tell my wife to try beers, because she takes that first sip and she goes, I don't like it.
You gotta.
But then I tell her, I was like, you have to sip it again.
Oh yeah.
Like right after.
It's all about it. Well, especially with some of the styles like sours and stuff, a sour right away is going to like punch you in the palate.
Super tart.
Exactly. But that second, that third sip, when your buds start to mellow out and realize what's going on and the rest of the layers of that can come off on you.
I always feel like Ratatouille when I'm like tasting beers, because I get like, I'm like, oh, and I can feel like there's grapefruit and
Thompson, is there something reading this can? Whew. They are going for it.
Oh shit! Yeah, they did.
This might need to get a roll on the table first.
Hold on.
What are we doing to
sit right now?
Yeah,
the Cicerone. Yeah,
Scissor judge. What?
The scissor judge.
Scissor judge.
Scissor judge. What did you just do?
You get a. This is a nice IPA, so we'll talk about it right now. Sometimes when they do the suspense IPAs, you'll get that, let's just say, sediment that sits down in the bottom.
Oh.
So if you give your can a nice little roll before you pop her open.
See, I've always wanted to know how to get rid of that sediment.
So what I do is I just pour and I leave like this.
A little bit in the bottom.
And I just let the foam die down and I just dunk.
All right. Now, you guys are way past episode 8, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we just released episode 33 yesterday.
And was it the first one you did out of social distance, or are you still doing – or how are you guys doing the show now?
A majority of our show is done – Dan and I do it in studio together because we're clean boys. And we usually have a guest on Skype just to be safe, you know. Practice social distancing as best as we can.
You guys really do look alike. Like when I look at you, your little boxes, like you look really much alike.
Yeah,
like,
is there a reason that you're like?
I made sure I wore my hat. He did
glasses. I'm doing glasses. He did flat bill. I'm doing flat bill.
It's just a very happy happenstance.
Yeah. So usually I have my hat backwards, and then he has his hat forwards. In solidarity, I've been trying to just look more like him.
Right. I mean, everyone needs a little someone sometimes. So it's like, you know, maybe it's the same person. How far do you live physically, geographically?
10 minutes.
Yeah. Embarrassingly close.
Like cul-de-sac close? Like,
oh, no. Different town, different boroughs.
Different boroughs. We couldn't be that close. It'd just get too weird. We'd be hanging out all the time.
Drinking beer all the time.
Yeah, well, I do live embarrassingly close to Dan's parents.
Yeah, he's like neighbors with him. I either walk his dog and say hi to my parents.
There's
wow.
Same, Josh. Same.
Which one's the one on the right, Dan? There seems to be a lot of like animals walking behind you.
Name
I'd
tags.
Like to be introduced to some of your friends.
So yeah, my last name is actually Doolittle. So this is just my animal arc that I have going on back here.
Yeah, there was like a cat and then it disappeared. And now there's like dog.
There's a dog right there. Yeah, it's just hanging out.
If you could like blow that up a little bit, we could see like the whole okay, it's a dog.
Don't look too far. There's some laundry behind the behind the sofa.
Some undies.
Right there. It's
we don't know
what. All right, now she's just showing off now.
I want to know what Jeremy's asking. How far are you guys from Breezewood?
Two and a half, 3 hours, give or take.
That's where D-Naps wanted to meet. All right, so we did a show last season where Kara came on and we brought three bachelors on and she ended up picking D-Naps and he was dead set on meeting her at Breezewood, but she lives in D.C.
So, that's a great meeting point.
Yeah, it really is, like, right?
That's like the perfect meeting point.
Listen, it's romantic.
Okay.
DC. I mean, there's
Tales all the time.
Can I tell you? I had my memorable Wendy's experience from Breezewood in senior year of high school. I had the best spicy chicken sandwich I've ever like. It's ingrained in my mind.
Wow, talk dirty to me. I mean,
he still texts me about it.
We're with you, bro. Like, we get it.
It was one of those sandwiches. Like, I bit into it and I was like, it's never going to get better than this.
Yeah. Well, but that's
I've hit my peak. I've hit my peak. It's senior year of high school.
That's how I feel like every time I eat a spicy chicken from Wendy's, though.
Travis, I did a little bit.
That's the best. Yeah. I was going to say, truckers get people pregnant in Breezewood.
Dairy Queen is all I remember from Breezewood. It's wonderful. It's a nice.
Tara, would you have met Darren in Breezewood for a quickie in a car?
I mean, it was like the depths of quarantine. It was Dairy Queen.
Desperation is a lot lizard in Breezewood.
It was Breezewood. And with all of that. No, it would not.
you know they call Breezewood the oasis in the desert that is central Pennsylvania.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's like the south of France for Pennsylvania.
Ibiza.
Yeah, so I paint my whole body and my face and everything when I go to Breezewood, just like I do when I go to Ibiza.
who did that song about Ibiza? What was that? Who was that guy?
Avicii.
Ibiza.
Oh, wait, no.
Avicii died of an overdose in Breezewood because of Ibiza. So that's how bad it was. That's how bad Breezewood is.
So what's next for the podcast, fellas?
Beer. Lots of beer.
Terrible jokes like that one.
Yeah. Yep. Hey,
my BFF Sarah, we're just hanging out at home. It looks like we're in Miami or something. Sorry, I know we're going to the podcast, Bill, but hi,
Sarah. How's it going, Sarah?
It's going great.
How's being a mom?
It's going great. I haven't stayed up till 10:42 in quite some time.
Well, we are honored.
This is pretty late for.
Let me ask you a question. Would you swipe if you were not married with a kid? Would you swipe right on this guy?
Absolutely.
What about this guy?
Don't let Tim see this. And what about that guy? Sure.
And what about this?
You know what? At this point, I'll take a sure.
Yeah. 100%. 100%. What about Tim? Put it on you. Nope.
Oh,
damn.
Damn!
Cold as ice.
Great seeing you, Sarah. I'm so glad you're on. Do you have anything you want to share? Are you drinking? Are you able to drink now?
Yeah. Well, I mean, Dave Rock says Harriet Bruce. Yes, she is able to drink. She's able to intermittently drink and, you know, feed and do all the milk stuff. But I think she's doing other things.
Wow.
So baby now sleeps for 8 hours. So I put him down at 7:30 PM and he sleeps till 3 o'clock in the morning. So then I can drink. So she can stay up till 3 basically. So we're ready.
Kara and I, the only party. Kara, we're the only two on this stream without children.
That's true. I was gonna say it was like my kids slept 8 hours right out of the womb. She was like out the first night.
Oh damn. Lucky. My kid woke up every 3 hours for the first 8 weeks and it was terrible. And then suddenly
if you mix a little Mad Dog in with the formula And it,
be what you do is you rub the Mad Dog on the gums. That's
but you got to be responsible. You can only do the orange Mad Dog so they get that vitamin C.
Exactly, Tom. Good point. Good point. But you want to rub it on the gums.
I like that Travis says, drink at 3 a.m. Yeah, they should be back at 3. We'll be fine. We'll be up by 3.
While Sarah's here, should we get to our bracket for the night?
Yeah, let's do it. I mean, I don't know how she's. It seems like she's passing through maybe for the bathroom or a drink, but I'm letting her. I'm in her home.
Are you going to use Mike's bathroom?
I'll be back because she's at my house.
All right, great. We'll see you soon.
We need to stretch a show out. I have another beer to drink.
I know. I just poured a fresh one.
I wanted to run this past you, this beer.
Oh, yeah. Let's run the beer past.
All right. Yeah. Let's do a beer judging. So, what's the name of the brewery on this?
This is called Jackie's Pub and Brewery. And it's called Who Cooks for You? Double dry hopped hazy pale ale.
Ooh.
Ooh. Okay.
Ooh.
I'm a big fan of the double dry hop.
Yeah,
she's gonna pop the mic screen.
I was gonna say, if you gotta pop that, let's drink it.
Should I do it? Okay. Ooh. I don't know where should we know? Should you know where it's from? I don't know.
You said it's Jackie's Pub and Brewery.
Yeah, Athens, Ohio.
Oh okay. Wow!
So it's taking a journey. Oh, drinking straight out of the can, ballsy. I like it.
Yeah, I've been a cup guy recently. We've developed quite the glass collection.
Yeah.
Look at you with your – he's got his stem glass over there. Look at Tom over there like a bougie motherfucker.
This is a Cicerone-approved glass.
It is Cicerone-approved.
So, yeah. Tell us the flavors that you're getting. Did you do
– Yeah, let's pretend she's on the show.
Yeah.
Now, you got it. All right, so did you do what our Cicerone told us? Small sip, then big gulp.
Oh, shoot.
You got to coat the palate.
I always do.
Saucy.
So that's a small.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Now experience the flavors. Not okay. Through your nose.
Yeah, it's okay. You can swallow on this show.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget to cup the balls.
Yeah, that's good. That's all I know. I mean, if I had to like maybe
is it bitter? Is it
wine? Okay.
Oh, what? Whoa. Jesus.
Oh, shit. I'm going to finish the red wine. See, this is why we do Sims TV, because it's a mess. And so
she's chasing a double.
Really, like, look at what it looks like.
Ugh. Her background is so nice with, like, the plant behind it. I feel like I'm watching someone from, like,
my house, but it's not my house.
I feel like I'm watching someone from Good Morning America get drunk.
Oh, Hoda. She's Hoda.
She's our Hoda.
This is the hazy pale ale.
Oh, we got some haze going.
Yeah, very hazy.
Mm-hmm. Right now, that's big with craft beer. Haze for days. People are all about the hazy boys. That's especially on social media. Everybody's got a hazy craze going on.
I mean,
I'm not about that life.
Except for Tom.
Who's not about that life? Who? Tom?
I'm not.
Why is that?
I don't know. They're just too... they're too generic at this point. Yes, chug it. Yes, yeah, Jeremy, you have the right idea.
I'm going to have to go with Jeremy on this. It's a small beer. If you're not chugging that, you're doing something
wrong. I'll chug with you.
Yeah, go for it.
I'll chug with you.
Yeah, but you're drinking. Also, I don't really chug that well.
I'm not going to chug.
All right.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Tom, what are you doing over here to yourself? Sip like a gentleman. Come on.
So right. I just chugged a double IPA from a company that is near Alexandria.
Oh, a little Aslan action.
Yeah, Aslan.
Did you get company. That? Is that the Vapid? Did you crack into it? Oh, baby boy, how was it?
It was delicious.
I just chugged a PBR, and I feel like I traveled back in time 20 years.
I feel like when I look at you, I travel back in time 20 years because I'm looking at old Jonah Hill.
Oh, well.
Mike has the...
That's or, about it.
Sims has
you
made
like
a...
good hazy? You love a good hazy.
Look at that. He's got a little hazy. What was that? Is that a like 20 ounce?
Or I know.
Is that
it looks tall and skinny. Like
19.2.
Oh, okay. That's
for
a
the record,
weird...
Jonah fun. Hill is old. So just want to establish that real quick. And in my youth,
How much have you talked about your movie, Sims?
On this show?
Yes.
I think everyone knows about it. I mean, we got a poster back here, but we had to hide Brian Callum as he's a rapist.
As West Coast comedy falls apart.
But
more offensive, he had eyelid surgery.
Yeah, he had one thing he wasn't supposed to do, rape women, and he did it. And, you know, not on my movie because there was no one to rape, but he's a bastard and we don't like him. But, I was in a movie called The 41-Year-Old Virgin who knocked up Sarah Marshall and felt super bad about it. Still get those residual checks.
They talked about that a bunch on a 10-minute podcast, and Callan was not a fan of that.
No, he was not. He was a money grab for him. Literally, it was a bunch of like kids that were PAs that looked like the other cast that they hired for the movie, and
that makes sense.
I got the job. Yeah. He was not. I mean, but the joke was on him. Why was he in that fucking movie with us, loser?
Money grab.
Yeah, well,
it's an 8.5 on IMDb.
Holy too low, shit. Jeremy. Too low.
8.5. I don't know. I still get those residual checks, and you can check that out on Amazon Prime anytime. Speaking of residual checks, I just want to give a quick plug for next week. Next week, we got my friend Allison from New York coming on. She's an actress in the theater world, and she's going to play a game called Win Vince's Residual Check. Our writer and fellow actor, Vince Eustace, is going to come on with a fat residual check, and she's going to try to beat him in a trivia game about me. And if she wins, she takes home all the cash.
So spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. She's going to cancel, and Dan and I will be on next week.
Again. Yeah,
we'll be back, guys. Don't worry. You guys know you're enjoying this.
You guys have a chance to win $2.95 between the two of you.
That's more than we've made with our podcast.
Come on back on. We'll play Win Vince's Residual. Let's get to our bracket so we can get the fans interactive. We decided
I'm really curious about what this bracket is.
Yeah, the bracket is, it's pretty much what it is. It's a bracket, and we usually bring up topics, and we see what's best and what's worst. And today we're going to play, the worst sports teams, the worst sports teams' names. Mike, you got the controls on this?
Hello.
I guess you do.
I didn't even ask for that. Like, no, that was like, you didn't.
Why,
was,
Mike?
Yeah, Mike. Way to go, Mike.
That was too forceful.
All right. So,
I love that people. Wait, no, people. Commenters are thinking that it's like they're guessing.
Cats on the steps.
Which is funny. They're guessing the names of the mascots.
Should we play that game instead?
Guess the logo. Guess the name based on the logo.
Guess the logo.
All right, Mike, put it up. Put the first one up. We'll play guess the logo. I've
read the notes and I still don't know what it is. Like, is it fiery ducks? Is it tire swoop ducks? Tire.
I feel like this duck is mid angry orgasm.
Hold on a second, guys. Hold on a second.
Oh God.
Wait. He has it.
Oh no.
No, he doesn't.
Put it up, Sims. No.
How many hats do you have under your desk right now?
There it is, baby.
Is it a mighty duck? Is it a tire duck?
It's the rubber ducks.
Josh Larkin for the win.
Why do you have that hat?
Ooh, maybe it's just like whoever wins the duck.
Whoever guesses it, I'm mailing them the hat.
That was Josh Larkin.
Nice long.
Why do you have that hat?
I liked it. I'm a big fan of minor league hats.
Oh, then you're gonna love this whole game.
Yeah. Oh no, spoiler alert, I've looked ahead. I'm a huge fan of minor league teams because they have the best logos.
It's all marketing for those teams. Like
Josh, you'll get my lice, and you'll like it.
You will.
All right, so Mike, bring up the next one since we got that one. Oh, here we go. What's the name of this?
Oh, this is like Pancake Man. This is like Stacks
McPancakes.
Oh, this is the IHOP Generals.
I love, I mean, I like relate. Like if you put that thing up and then you put my face up, it's like the same thing. Like I feel like it's just.
Hey, do it. Hold on. Put it up, Mike.
Are we just zooming in on Kara?
It's just Kara now.
Mike, put up the logo, please. I'm just seeing.
Yeah, Kara. No, I think it looks good. It's the exact same. We couldn't be more alike.
That's how I spend most of my day. It's just
a slab of butter in your mouth.
Yeah, no, I think that looks great.
The flapjacks, the Danbury dingleberry.
The butter suckers, which is just, come on.
Josh is just killing it over here.
Yeah. Josh is the MVP of this episode.
I mean, I think it's the flapjacks.
It's actually the Montgomery biscuits. Put that back up. Is that a biscuit?
That's not a biscuit, though.
That looks like French toast.
It looks like a biscuit with feet.
I mean,
that looks like the burger that came to life in Better Off Dead.
It's like McDonald's hotcakes with shoes.
Yeah. I hear Van Halen behind it.
It said Fargo flapjacks.
Yeah, there you go, hotcakes.
The bunker bitches. Bitch ass. That's who we are.
Funny story. Very close to buying a Birmingham biscuits hat.
Well, you got to get one now.
Well, yeah, I mean now.
I was waiting for you to like swap the hats. I'm like, and go.
Yeah.
Where? What do we got next, Mike?
Some of these actually say the name, so
that's okay.
Well, then throw it up. Throw it just up. Throw. I was... there. Oh wow, fighting artichoke.
Oh, that's scary though. Look at all those spiky things.
There's a thin line between an artichoke and what looks like a beer hop. So this is like very close to that.
Oh my god, are you guys turned on? Do you feel something Do you feel something rumbling in your tumblies and in your?
I'm pushing up against my denim.
Yeah, I was gonna say, are you gonna push denim? I knew you were gonna fucking say that. Best friends.
Which one's next, Mike? This one next. This one's great. This team's called FL Fart.
It's the football fart, guys.
I'm more concerned about the football get.
No, I'm not concerned about that.
I never want to experience right there.
No, a fart. Joke, no matter, I don't care how you slice it, is the funniest thing. Fart or poop is the funniest thing you've ever experienced. Like, it's a great joke, no matter what. It doesn't matter. Like, if we were doing a bracket right now, fart joke would 100%.
Speaking of fart joke, should we check in on the fart chair?
Go for it, baby.
No farts tonight.
Zero farts today.
It's fucking not doing it. All right, what's next? Oh, the next is. There it is. Hold on.
Oh, damn! I see where you're going with this one.
So, as a dirtbag, I feel triggered.
Yeah. I know a few Long Beach dirtbags, but
I feel like on the East Coast it'd be like Long Island dirtbags.
That's actually the name for the California State University of Long Beach, the Long Beach Dirtbags.
Damn.
Which was most of Robert Morris, anyway.
Yeah, pretty much. It was most of G Tower. All right, let's bring up the next one because this one doesn't have anything to it. Guess this one.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Is that a
snail? I know what it is. What is but it? I won't say it.
What is it?
I'm not going to say it. I'm going to let them.
Oh, you know the answer.
The freaking audience.
The slug trails.
Yeah, I was going to say, is that the slug trails?
Slug, but a little more specific than that. Okay, Travis. No.
It's the slug trails, right?
Well, it could be the sex slugs. It could be the slippin' willies. It could be.
What the fuck is a slippin' willy?
Could be the sluggers, but no. It's the
Mike, throw up the next photo. Everyone knows this probably. That's from Pulp Fiction.
Oh shit, the banana slugs?
Yeah, the banana slugs. You see Santa Cruz banana slugs.
That's right, motherfucker.
Yeah. Look at the big brains on Brad over here.
All right, put up the next one.
Now Mike, Sims is pushing denim.
The trash pandas. I know this one.
Oh, there we go. The trash pandas.
Oh yeah, that was a big article. There's a big thing about this one.
Why is the trash can a rocket and it has?
Why does it have controls on the outside?
Put that back.
Why does it have controls on the outside?
It looks like he's wearing a power glove.
Yeah, it is really strange.
I'm showing my age right there with the power glove.
Yeah, red, white, and blue, baby, America. Those colors don't run.
And
nothing says America like a trash panda.
This last one is it has the name, but I think they're really known for as the shit stains.
Well, hold on. Speaking of that, did you hear what one of their players likes?
Oh yeah, I heard about this. Yeah, it makes it even funnier. The Cleveland Browns.
No one likes to eat ass?
On two different fronts.
Wait, guys, wait, can you bring that up again, Mike? I'm perplexed by this logo. I'm trying to figure out who this team is, and I can't
I feel like I'm looking into a butthole.
Oh, the Cleveland Concussion Giveners. Is that what it is?
Oh, look at you. Oh, you got a little hate over there.
Yeah. The Mason Rudolph Targets. Is that what it is?
New Orleans Baby.
Folks. Okay. Folks.
It's the Cleveland Steamers, man. Come on.
So what are you guys up to the rest of the night? It's kind of late there, and you're both parents. So you're staying up? You're going to keep drinking?
I'm going to fall asleep immediately as soon as we're done.
Yeah. Sounds
lame. So you're not coming to the after party?
Is there an after party?
Usually we do a Zoom after party.
Oh, I was not informed of this, but yes.
Yeah, you didn't tell us about this on the email.
Depends how you
real
do
professional.
Show. Hold on. Anya said it best. The Cleveland Brown town.
Well, a certain player on the Cleveland Browns enjoys the old Cleveland Steamer, apparently.
Oh, hey. Is that when you shit on someone's chest?
Apparently, yes. And I mean, you're hitting on two fronts. You got Cleveland and you got Browns right there.
But sometimes you can veer off into the Sylvester Stallone territory of the Cleveland glass bottom boats.
Yikes.
Yeah.
Well, Sims' favorite is the upper decker.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, the upper decker. When you shit in the girl's head.
Jesus. God damn. You're like Bizarro Jonah Hill over there. This is an evil guy.
Yeah, no, Jonah Hill's a bastard. Wait till I launch my new podcast with Josh Larkin. We talk all about it. Guys, do you have any plugs or anything? Because I'll forget to get to them. You guys want to plug anything?
Oh, hell yeah.
Send it out. What do you got? Oh, wait, hold on. We got a special guest before we get to your plugs. So are those pink pants?
The special guest is a very tightly fit shirt.
Look at that.
It's a husband.
It's a proprietor.
House husband.
House husband.
That's how I look on vacation.
Like, they're like all hugging and like, it's fine. I mean, like with masks.
It's okay. Kara, we know you're not quarantined.
Those buttons were living dangerously cheesy.
All right. So what do you guys got to plug?
Dan?
Should I do the plugs?
Sure.
All right. Well, on Instagram and Facebook, you can follow us at Best Best Friends Pod. That's at Best Best Friends P-O-D. Also, if you want to email us beer suggestions, we have a Gmail account. It's bestbestfriendspod@gmail.com. It's at bestbestfriendspod.
And if you were listening to the podcast, this is where I would play a POD drop from the band POD.
I love that you guys have the drop.
I love POD.
Oh, there we go.
Everybody loves Christian new metal.
Can we get a copy of this video so we can pull the audio record up? I love POD. I want that on our keyboard so we can hit it every time.
Let's get it clean. Kara, stop sidebarring. Give us that I love POD again.
I love POD.
Oh, I'm going to hear that when I go to sleep. That's my ASMR.
I will pull that for you and send it to you. You guys own it now. It's yours.
Also, if you want great beer-related clothing, go to beerbelliesclothing.com.
Oh, and yeah, we have a sponsor.
Use promo code BBFPOD. for 20% off.
20% off. Yeah.
20% off. I've never had that before.
Yeah, get your hoodies, t-shirts. They have gaiters, whatever you need.
They got some pretty good hats too, man. I love their
Fat Mike. They got Fat Matt Mike. They got crop tops.
Hey, Fat Matt.
Fat Matt. Fat Matt.
Wait, have we gotten to the Fat Mike video, pictures that we have at all?
No, I didn't put them on. I figured the Baywatch was enough for him tonight. I love him too much to throw up pictures of him passed out at someone's wedding. Wait, hold on. We're going back to special guest here.
Yeah, Sarah, my hair looks terrible.
Wait, get in here, Sarah. I've got all my wife and my husband.
This is how it happens.
Hang out together.
This is how you get baby number 2 and 3.
Oh shit!
But there's
that's how you get your second and third baby on the same night.
No way.
Are we conferencing in this? Oh, we are.
Oh, hey, geez, yeah, I can see that.
We have a party going on.
Everyone's quarantine out there.
Are we conferencing the scissor judge into this?
We're fine. We are fine.
All right, guys.
Tight shirt shooting for the belt tonight.
All right, fellas. Kara, send up the after party email or whatever you do. I'll send it to Dan and Tom. Dan, Tom, thank you so much for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having us on, man. This was a blast.
Oh, yeah. Give us your website one more time.
Just follow us on Instagram at BestBestFriendsPod. That's at BestBestFriendsPod. Here in the South Town, baby. Where the
I love POD.
Yeah.
What is going on here? This is
We're on all major podcast platforms, too. So
I said 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, Kara's going to be live on OnlyFans later tonight. Throw some tips.
Are you guys liking using Anchor? You're using Anchor, right?
Yes.
Anchor.fm.
I know Anchor.
All
right. Well, Mike, you got anything else to say?
No, I got to go pack the truck and then drive 9 hours tomorrow.
They're at the beach.
Jesus so you Christ, will not you... be at the after party.
Oh, come to the after party.
Come, Fat Matt. Come on.
I got to pack the truck. Fat Matt.
Come on, Fat Matt. Let's go.
Fat Matt. Come on.
All right. Well, I'm Steven Sims. This is Sims TV. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you at the after party. Peace and love. Bye.
Bye.